Good afternoon, and welcome to this episode of Piping Up. We're delighted that you've joined us. This show is presented by the Tabernacle Choir at Temple Square and streams every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon Mountain Time on the Tabernacle Choir's website and YouTube channel and at broadcasts.churchofjesuschrist.org. You can find out more information about Piping Up, including downloadable programs for this week's episodes and all previous episodes, at tabchoir.org/pipingup. Our featured performer today is Brian Mathias, playing the Schoenstein organ in the Conference Center. His program opens with the hymn, Jehovah, Lord of Heaven and Earth. We just heard Brian Mathias play Jehovah, Lord of Heaven and Earth, an 18th century American hymn tune that many people know by another title, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. That arrangement was by John Longhurst, who was, of course, a former Tabernacle organist and the prime mover in acquiring for the Conference Center this splendid organ you see behind me. Brian will now play the Ronde Française by Léon Boëllmann. Although he's known primarily for organ music, Boëllmann actually wrote this piece for piano. Soon after it was published in 1896, it was transcribed numerous times for organ and is now heard most frequently as an organ recital work. If you're familiar with Boëllmann's Suite Gothique, you might be a little surprised by how rustic and folksy this dance is, but the modal harmony will still sound familiar. You're watching Piping Up, organ concerts at Temple Square. These concerts are streamed every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon Mountain Time right here, where you're watching us now. Sometimes a piece of music goes through several iterations. It can be difficult to nail down the one true version because each of the various forms says its own thing, even if they all share some fundamental similarities. Now, that's certainly the case with the next work on the program. It started out as an aria, Ombra mai fu, in Francesco Cavalli's opera Circe from 1654. That aria and its music were then adapted by Giovanni Bononcini, who set the same story as an opera 40 years later. Then, in 1738, Handel set the opera again and adapted Bononcini's aria. Now, it doesn't stop there. The music from Handel's version of Circe was forgotten for nearly 200 years after its premiere, except for this one aria. It was rediscovered in the 19th century, transcribed for all kinds of instrumental performance, and retitled Handel's Largo. Then it was turned into a sacred choral anthem by Alfred William Phillips with the words, "Holy art thou." Now, which of these is the real, true version of this music? Actually, all of them. There's something uniquely beautiful about each of them that the others don't have, though they share much of the same musical material. This kind of diversity, this variety of iteration that springs from a similar source, is everywhere in music, and it's part of the divinity of creation. The Quran teaches that God made us different from each other so that we may know each other. There isn't just one proper way to be a child of God. Each of us shares a divine heritage, and we express the beauty of that heritage in the very diversity that God intended for us. Now we'll hear just one of many equally beautiful versions of the music known here as Handel's Largo in G. Thank you. Today's organist, Brian Mathias, just performed his own arrangement of Come, Come Ye Saints. Next, the old melody that he's chosen for this concert is the hymn tune, The King of Love, My Shepherd Is. And it's a very old melody, an ancient tune, in fact, from Ireland. It's often also paired with the hymn text, Dear Refuge of My Weary Soul. Then we'll close with Bach's incomparable Toccata and Fugue in D minor. And there's a bit of a local connection to this work. The first recording ever made of Bach's Toccata and Fugue, and also the first successful commercial recording made of a pipe organ anywhere, was in 1910, and it was a performance by Tabernacle organist John J. McClellan, made just across the road in the Salt Lake Tabernacle. So, 110 years later, Tabernacle organist Brian Mathias will round out this concert with that same epic organ work. But first, The King of Love, My Shepherd Is. Whether that music makes you think of Sunset Boulevard, Phantom of the Opera, or Rollerball, I guess depends on what generation you belong to. In any case, it's always a hit as a concert finale. We hope you enjoyed this presentation of Piping Up with Brian Mathias playing the Schoenstein organ in the Conference Center on Temple Square. If you'd like to join us again for more inspiring organ music, Piping Up streams every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon Mountain Time on the Tabernacle Choir's website and YouTube channel and on broadcasts.churchofjesuschrist.org.